Meghan Markle is set to finish off her surprise trip to New York in true style by attending a lavish baby shower thrown for her by Serena Williams and Amal Clooney in America's most expensive hotel room, and $75,000 a night penthouse suite. It had been previously reported that the event, which is said to be the main reason for the 7 months pregnant royal secret trip to the Big Apple, had taken place on Tuesday. However, a source close to the 37-year-old royal claims that it is scheduled for Wednesday, shortly before Meghan is set to return to London. Speaking to Tatler, the source revealed that the baby shower will be held in the penthouse suite at the Mark Hotel on New York's Upper East Side, where Meghan and her friend Serena, 37, are both thought to have stayed on Tuesday evening, after enjoying dinner together at a swanky Manhattan restaurant. Although it is not known whether Meghan has been staying in the penthouse for her entire trip, which began on Friday when she flew in from London after spending Valentine's Day with her husband Prince Harry, the location will reportedly play host to the Duchess and several of her closest pals while they celebrate the upcoming arrival of Meghan and Harry's first child. According to Tatler's source, the location was chosen by Serena, who is a longtime fan of the Mark's in-house restaurant Jean George's. She is not thought to have stayed at the hotel before Tuesday night, when she and Meghan were pictured returning to the location after enjoying dinner with two of the royals' closest friends Jessica Maroney and Marcus Anderson. Both Jessica, 39, and Marcus are expected to attend the intimate baby shower on Wednesday, which is, according to sources, scheduled to take place at 12:30 p.m. On Tuesday evening, Meghan was pictured heading out to Ralph Lauren's swanky restaurant The Polo Bar on Tuesday night alongside fellow mothers Serena and Jessica, perhaps finalizing plans for the lavish baby shower set to take place today. Despite a busy day spent catching up with friends, Meghan looked fresh-faced and full of energy as she arrived at the high-end eatery, which is also known to be a favorite of President Donald Trump's, and is located just a few blocks from his tower on Fifth Avenue. The party spent 3 hours inside the restaurant before stepping back out into the chilly New York night. Meghan and Serena were then spotted arriving back at their lavish hotel, The Mark, on Manhattan's Upper East Side. The pregnant Duchess recycled the same $3,085, 2,250 pounds navy Victoria Beckham coat that she was seen wearing in images published exclusively by DailyMail.com on Monday evening. The first photos taken of Meghan since she arrived in the Big Apple on Friday evening. She paired the chic double-breasted coat with a black scarf, a pair of black satin boots, thought to be from Isabel Merritt, and a $1,140, 915 pounds, black chain-handle handbag by Vegan designer Stella McCartney. Meghan also modeled a much more glamorous makeup look than she had been seen wearing during the day, modeling a dark smoky eyeshadow, while emphasizing her natural pregnancy glow with some highlighter and bronzer. As the former actress climbed out of her SUV, which appeared to be the same State Department vehicle she has been using all day, she couldn't help but flash a wide smile, no doubt at the prospect of spending an evening with some of her closest pals, many of whom live an ocean away from the royals' home with Prince Harry at Kensington Palace. Not only is the Polo Bar known to be a much-loved celebrity haunt, the restaurant is also themed entirely around the popular equestrian sport from which it takes its name, a sport that Prince Harry has been playing for decades. Meghan and Serena have actually watched one of Harry's polo matches together, along with the tennis pro's husband Alexis Ohanian, who joined the two women to cheer on the prince in the Audi Polo Challenge in Oxfordshire back in July, not long after Meghan and Harry tied the knot. President Trump, Melania, and their son Baron also enjoyed dinner at the eatery back in June 2016, the night before Donald's 70th birthday, and just a few months before he went on to win the presidential election against Clinton. Meghan's evening outing comes after a busy day of activities for the royal, which started early in the afternoon when she was seen leaving high-end New York hotel The Mark to enjoy an afternoon out ahead of her baby shower. The 7 months pregnant royal was seen cradling her baby bump as she made her way to Medbrewer Museum, which is located just a few blocks away from the Mark Hotel, the rumored venue of the intimate baby shower being thrown for the royal by 15 of her nearest and dearest, with her former Suits co-star Abigail Spencer joining her for the quick city jaunt. Moments earlier, Meghan was pictured walking out of the five-star hotel at 1:05 p.m., Once again keeping a hand rested on her growing bump, surrounded by armed officers thought to be from the State Department, as well as several plainclothes royal protection officers, just moments after her close friend and former Suits co-star Abigail Spencer was pictured making her way into the venue. Taking advantage of what is a bright and sunny day in the Big Apple, Meghan wore a vintage gray Courageous coat for her surprise outing, pairing the outerwear with some skinny black jeans and some nude suede heels. She accessorized her ensemble with a pair of dark sunglasses, which hid much of her face from the cameras, and was seen carrying a dove gray handbag in the crook of her right arm, while the other hand was planted firmly on her large bump. Meghan was accompanied on the trip by what appeared to be several members of hotel security, as well as a handful of plainclothes police officers, including the same man seen escorting the mother-to-be out of a Manhattan apartment on Monday evening. Other than her impressive security detail, the royal appeared to be along as she made her way past photographers and into a waiting SUV, which had Department of State license plates. Abigail was the first of the royals' nearest and dearest to be seen making their way into the Mark Hotel on New York's Upper East Side, trying to maintain a low profile by wearing a gray beanie hat and large, dark sunglasses as she made her way inside, flashing a wave at the waiting photographers on her way in. She spent just a few minutes in the hotel, taking the time to change up her outfit slightly, before heading out again to join Meghan at the Med Brewer. Abigail first sparked speculation that she had traveled to the Big Apple for the special occasion after sharing an airport selfie on her Instagram account on Monday, less than 24 hours before she was seen making her way into the Mark, shortly after bouquets of flowers, an orange tree, and a $380 travel crib were seen being delivered to the swanky venue. As well as her shades and hat, the actress was dressed in a thick black parka with a fur-lined hood upon her arrival, showing off just a hint of the more colorful, stylish pink dress seen poking out from underneath the thick winterwear. Although the rest of the guest list for the event is not yet confirmed, there are two people close to Meghan who are likely not going to be in attendance, including her beloved mother Doria Ragland, 62, who was pictured walking her dog at home in Los Angeles on Tuesday, while her daughter was preparing for the swanky event. Meghan's close pal and fellow screen star Priyanka Chopra, who was a guest at the former Suits star's wedding to Prince Harry, all but confirmed that she would not be attending the baby shower, when she posted a selfie on her Instagram account on Tuesday afternoon, and listed Beverly Hills, California, as the geographical location of the snap. Indeed, other than Misha and Abigail, none of Meghan's other more high-profile pals, including the likes of Jessica Maroney and Serena Williams, were pictured arriving at the hotel during the day. However, it is possible they chose to stay at the pricey venue, and therefore did not have to venture out ahead of the shower. Suits star Sarah Rafferty, brand consultant Benita Litt, and college pal Lindsay Roth were also among the friends who were believed to be attending Meghan's shower. However, as of 6 p.m. on Tuesday evening, they had not been seen outside the hotel. On Monday night, the Duchess attempted to go incognito as she covered up in a cap and long navy Victoria Beckham overcoat and a gray newsboy cap pulled down over her dark brown hair, and with her large diamond engagement ring clearly visible on her wedding finger. Meghan returned to the Big Apple over the weekend to spend time with her girlfriends before the arrival of her first child this spring, and was seen on Monday evening being escorted into an SUV by a royal protection officer. The palace declined to comment on Meghan's security detail for the duration of the trip, or the plainclothes officer seen accompanying her. Meghan is understood to have flown into the city on Friday for a surprise 5-day trip after spending a quiet Valentine's Day evening with her husband, Prince Harry. A spokesperson for Kensington Palace would not divulge details of the Duchess's flights, but confirmed that as this is a personal trip, her travel was privately funded. It is not known whether Meghan flew to New York on a commercial flight, or whether she was lucky enough to travel in a private jet. The royal certainly has her fair share of high-profile pals who may have been able to secure her access to a private plane. TV mogul Oprah, who was in attendance at the royal wedding, and is said to have formed a close bond with Meghan's mother Doria, owns a private jet, and once said of the plane that it was incredibly useful for making the exact trip that the Duchess of Sussex made on Friday. "I would say having your own airplane is the greatest luxury," Oprah told British Vogue editor Edward Enninful during a 2018 interview, before adding, "Because it means one minute you're in New York, and then the next minute you say, 'You know, Edward, I think I'll fly to London.'"